What is a switch and voltage adapter? It is a common power source or a power supply. You're free to call it as you see fit. Lightweight, compact design. A primitive, basic, simplified circuit with a pulse transformer result in such a small weight, which enables easy plug-in of the adapter into a wall outlet or a converter that will reliably hold the miniature construct in suspension for a long time. But still, any voltage adapter is designed for a specific operating mode, that is, load voltage and operating current, which ensures operation of household appliances or equipment even in peak load modes, specified on the adapter's label, since they lack technical certificates. Where are these certificates supposed to come from? We usually don't know anything about the manufacturer either. A quality power supply works for years without any claims or approaches to the manufacturer, who still makes himself known sometimes, depending on his worldwide reputation. However, the number of well-known companies is small, and why would they bother making such low-priced goods? Thus, everyone can feel free to manufacture these products, provided they at least know something about them, more specifically about their design. Key aspects are fast, invest numbers, and cheap, never mind the quality, as long as they are at least able to function. So which typical failures occur in switch and voltage adapters as they are used with household appliances? Let us review these as exemplified by one of such devices that has failed due to hyperintensive labor. First, we look at the label. Input voltage 12 volts. Load current 1200 milliamperes. Very promising indeed. A small one, and yet hardworking. Dismantling revealed nothing good except for the compactness of electronic components mounting. We have measured and soldered out all damaged parts that had caused this power adapter to fail. A microchip, the so-called PWM controller. Although, what's really so special about it? Just the power transistor and a key. Its marking is popular, SM8002C, although it is not to be found on the lists, that is, data sheets. Moving on, a 15-volt Zener diode, whose purpose was to protect the chip from breakdown. Well, didn't quite succeed. A slippery and cutting circuit element, opto-isolator. Not only does it decouple power, but also control secondary circuit. You'd better keep an eye on it, unless you want to replace a whole load of microchips, one after another, just because you hadn't tested it. Well, and the rest, too. Don't be lazy and check capacitors to avoid voltage collapse into the secondary circuit. The last thing is the fuse. It is the last one to blow, although this is correct. After all, the load is preserved undamaged, although this is not always the case. Generally, this is it. The most pleasant thing remaining, replacement of damaged circuit elements and further adapter use. And still, please pay attention to the power adapter's technical specifications and avoid loading it to capacity in terms of load current. The peak current calculated by the equipment's owner does not always correspond to the circuit design, which ultimately affects its operating capability.